Shabbat Shalom, everyone. Expected it to be a little louder. It's been a few weeks. Shabbat Shalom. It's so nice to be back here after a short sabbatical. When I was doing Hannah's bedtime last week, she, like most five-year-olds, keeps talking, tries to delay bedtime, and she's like, "Hey, Abba." I said, "Hey, Hannah." And she said, "Remember Bethel?" That's when I knew that it was time. It had been quite long. It was time for us to come back to this community, which so grateful to be a part of. I had a number of colleagues ask how I was spending my time during sabbatical, assuming that I would be learning somewhere. I had colleagues who worked in academia asking what my book was about that I would be writing, because that is the sort of expectation in the world of universities, that when you take sabbatical, you have to publish something. And I responded with each question and inquiry that I would be spending my time with my family. And so grateful for this community to allow me to do so, because I found that the sabbatical that I needed to take was about re-energizing, rejuvenating. It was about spending those sacred moments with those sacred people that I love. And I found that there's nothing more sacred, as all of you know, than being in relationship with those people who are most important to us. That it's those relationships that we're in that's where we find God the most. Between spouses, between siblings, between parents and children. And so it was the opportunity to spend more time in those sacred and holy relationships that I came to appreciate all the more so the holiness of God within those relationships. But I also found that as I was preparing to return sabbatical, I found myself a little sad. Probably no different than a parent when they are returning from parental leave, or a stay-at-home parent who, after a long period of time, returns to the workforce. Sad because you also know that time is a fickle thing, that there's never enough time. There's never enough time to do all that we want to do with the people we love and with the promises that we make or say that we are going to keep. And I was meeting with a teacher and colleague and mentor of mine, Rabbi Paula Drill, and she said that every time she would take sabbatical, that she would make a havdalah of sorts. I thought about it a lot, the idea of ritualizing the end of Shabbat. She reminded me that havdalah is not about saying goodbye to Shabbat, but rather it's about taking these sacred moments of Shabbat with us, right? With each ritual we do, with our wine and spices and twisted candle, our goal is really to take Shabbat with us and carry it with us for the rest of the week, to make each and every day of the week a little bit more kadosh. And so I said, that's wonderful. How do I know we're at the busyness of the world. So how do I take the experiences I had during sabbatical with me? She said, part of it is holding on to those memories and making those relationships more of a priority. Holding on to those memories. And it's so happens that she brought that up to me days before we have the Shabbat of Shabbat Zachor, where we're commanded to remember in a very negative sense. We're commanded to remember not for good, not hold on to those memories like a locket around our necks, but hold on to those memories of the terrible things that happened to us out of fear that they may happen again. Right? We just read in our Maftir reading of the Amalekites of Amalek attacking us from behind in the wilderness. And we read that on the Shabbat before Purim, because tradition teaches that Haman, that Haman, was a descendant of Amalek. Even when we remember the negative, though, our instinct is to focus on the joy. Because the holiday that we celebrate Monday night and Tuesday is not Tisha B'Av, right? That's the Amalekites attacked us from behind, and we don't spend time in mourning, in sackcloths, on the floor. We have the craziest day of the year. We spend time with authentic, unadulterated joy. We spend time in silliness. We spend time with our community. We spend time with our loved ones. We spend so much time that Talmud says, "Mishenichnas adar marbi misimcha," that we're actually supposed to increase our joy each and every day. So how do we remember, not just as I was tasked, how do I remember the parts of my sabbatical that I want to take back with me, but also how do we remember terrible aspects of Torah? We do so with joy, by holding on to that joy, and by acting those moments of joy. The Baal Shem Tov taught that Amalek is not just a people, Amalek is a state of mind, and a fear of how quickly we each in our own lives can become Amalek when we are selfish and self-centered, when we ignore those special and sacred relationships and only focus on ourselves, what we think is important and or what we deem important in that moment, instead of focusing on those who are important to us. How susceptible we each are when we focus on the negative and become the negative and neglect those relationships that are sacred. But we blot out Amalek by being joyful. And so, we do the opposite of what we read today. We focus on joy, we remember by being with those people that we love, remember by adding more joy to our lives, more light to a world full of darkness when we need it. So to make a havdalah for myself, selfishly upon returning from sabbatical, part of it is about remembering, and part of it is about remember through action, remember Amalek, and then we are joyful. It's about making more moments, making time for moments of joy in our lives, between each other, those that are sacred to us, those that we love. We live in a world that I am guilty of being too connected too often. One of the greatest gifts of these past 5 weeks was the ability to disconnect for me. Bill actually asked Rabbi Martyr, wanting to check up to make sure that I was following the rules and not responding to voicemail or to emails. The idea to disconnect and just to be present in our moments with the people that we love is something that none of us do enough of. Truthfully, it's the greatest blessing of Shabbat, to disconnect from the outside world and just be with each other. And so how do we make Havdalah? How do I? It's a promise that I am trying to make to myself, to disconnect more and more often, and to be, and to be present with those around me more often. And I task all of us with that. If I took one thing from this experience, to be present with each other more often, to disconnect more often, to think less about what's going on in the world around us, think less about what news or experiences or world I'm missing out on, and instead just focus on being present. I hope and pray to do the same, to hold myself accountable, and that we all can do so, to take the joy of Purim, to take the joy of relationships, make that a part of our everyday lives, to hold that joy, to carry that joy, and to have that joy carry us. Shabbat Shalom.